This is a demonstration of the simple pendulum. The simple pendulum is this kind of motion where you have a mass on the end of an ideally an inextensible string, a string that can't be stretched, and it oscillates with a particular period, and the period is defined as the time for one complete oscillation. So here it looks like the period is roughly 1 second, boom, boom, a little longer than a second, boom, et cetera, et cetera. So we want to think about today how that period depends on the various parameters of the problem. We'll work out in class, or have already worked out in class, the dependence of the period. The period is denoted by the capital letter T. And it goes like 2 pi the square root of L, which is the length of the pendulum, this length from the center of mass up to the point where it's attached, divided by g, the acceleration of gravity. And notice that this period does not depend on two things you might have thought that it could depend on: the amplitude of the motion, which is the angle from the vertical. This is the equilibrium position of the pendulum. If I put the ruler roughly where that vertical line is, and then I bring the pendulum out, the angle that is made between the green string here and the ruler is maybe about 10 or 15 degrees in this particular case. That is the amplitude. So if I release it from rest at that angle of, say, 15 degrees, then it will come down through the equilibrium position, go 15 degrees onto the other side, and then back and forth like that. So that's the amplitude. Let's first investigate the dependence of the period, the time for one complete oscillation, on the amplitude. At this amplitude, maybe 15 degrees, it's boom, 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 two, three, boom, two, three, about that. And let's try a smaller amplitude. Boom, two, three, boom, two, three, boom, two, three, boom, two, about the same. At least very difficult to detect any difference. Let's do this intermediate amplitude. Boom, two, three, boom, two, three, boom, two, three, etc. Galileo, when he was in church, back in Italy, there was a wind blowing through one of the windows, and there was a chandelier that was oscillating as a simple pendulum. And he, using his pulse as a stopwatch, timed the oscillations of that chandelier and determined to his satisfaction that the period does not depend on the amplitude. And in fact, the period does depend on amplitude. When the amplitude gets large, like this amplitude, the period is a little bit longer than it is for simple harmonic motion. But that calculation is a very difficult one to show the dependence of the period on the amplitude. What we'll do in class is to simply consider very small amplitudes, maybe about 10 degrees or smaller. And for small amplitudes, the period does not depend on the amplitude at all. It depends only on the length of the pendulum and the gravitational acceleration. The next interesting thing to look at is the dependence of the period on the mass. So let me do a small angle, so this equation will be valid. Boom, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Let's change the mass. This is 200 grams. And this is 100 grams. Use a small amplitude again. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. No change. We can even go to an even smaller mass, and you see again, one, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. No dependence on the mass. You can see that in this equation. So now let's look at the dependence of the period on the length. Clearly, this equation says that if you increase the length, given that the period depends on the square root of the length, then you will increase the period. So let's remind ourselves what the period is here with this particular length. Boom, two, three, boom, two, three, just as we had before. And let's increase the length then. Boom, two, three, boom, two, three, boom, two, three. So the period is now longer. The time for one complete oscillation is longer. It looks to be 2 or 3 seconds instead of roughly about 1 second. And that's consistent with the equation here. You could do more careful calculations, but that shows you the basic dependence of the period on the length, the independence of the period on the amplitude. And then the other thing that the period depends upon, of course, is gravitational acceleration. The Earth's gravity is 9.8 meters per second squared. If you were to take this pendulum and set it up exactly like this on the moon, where gravity is much less than it is on the Earth, you have a smaller gravitational acceleration. And given that that's in the denominator, you'd have a longer period. So it would take a longer time to make an oscillation with the same length that it would on Earth.